Chris from Webb Motorworks. We're just going over some components for the small block Chevy crate motor. As you know, it's going to be electric. These parts are made out of wood and Bondo. I take them over to Jim for making back, and then he brings them back like this, all cast in aluminum. Of course, I have to do machining on them, clean up the molds, drill holes, all that type of stuff. Then I'm going to take it to Brian over at Totten Welding, and he's going to weld them up for me, and then we'll do some assembly. So I'll let you have a look at that. Just like you're doing woodwork. Okay, so I gotta do some machining on my back plate here, my aluminum plate, and I don't have a milling machine. So I kind of thought, how am I gonna make this work? So I kind of built my own. This slides this way like this. And then I bolted the back piece onto this slide. And then this will slide like this. And I put a milling blade in my drill press, and let's just fire this baby up. What do you know? It works. Totten Welding. This is Brian. He welded up my engine for me. Any problems with this, Brian?
How did it go? Not at all. The cast was very clean. Yep. The weld went in good. Had to preheat.
Nice.
We had to dig back. We back welded it.
Yeah.
I dug down behind every weld just to make sure you had full penetration.
Right on. Wow.
But beautiful for a cast weld. Aluminum, it was some of the cleanest cast I've ever worked on.
Hey Ron, check these welds out inside here. I don't know if you can.
Beautiful, he did a beautiful job.
To use wire on a cast is pretty, it's pretty amazing. Like,
so
it was so clean.
MIG or TIG you
did? We used MIG and then I TIG wrapped the corners after I dug them out just to make sure a fusion and what have you.
Right on.
But it's gonna be a strong unit, that's for sure.
Well, thank you very much.
Hey, anytime.
Good job.
Yeah, right hope on. To see the end result.
Very good.
These welds and stuff here, I'm just going to clean them up a little bit. They were made a little bit big, so I just got to make it look like a more of a motor, you know? Just cut some of that stuff off right now. Seeing this as an electric motor, I was thinking I should paint this orange because it's a small block, but I could shine it up and make it like buffed aluminum, polished aluminum, something like that. That might look cool. Maybe it's a waste of time, I don't know. Okay, so we're gonna play around, make sure things fit here. What I got here is the heat sink for the controllers, and I had to do a bit of tapping, and I'm running lines. These are going to be the cooling lines. And because this is a prototype, I've realized I need little flanges on here, so I'll actually cast them in the next one. But for now, I've just bolted piece on. And I'll probably just weld this in place, because eventually I'm going to have to cast a few tabs in here like that. And so this is where the controller's fitting. These water lines will come in and cool it. The controller, I have two controllers.
So this is the one controller here is going to fit like that. And then the next piece is the head, which I've got here. It's a hollow head. Did a little buffing on it. Make it, you know, I thought I'd make it look nice and shiny rather than paint it. And my concern is, man, is this all going to fit together? So it actually does. This head goes on here like this. Okay, then I'll just drill and tap that and assemble this and carry on with a few other things.